Hey guys, in this video we are going to see what is a Pythagoras theorem, and we'll also learn how to prove Pythagoras theorem by many ways. Now before we start, let us see what exactly is Pythagoras theorem. Now let us see what are the sides of right angle triangle called. Now if you have a right angle triangle like this with side A, B and C. A is called as the height, B is the base of the triangle, and C is the hypotenuse of the triangle. Now the Pythagoras theorem, it says that in a right angle triangle, the sum of squares of sides is equal to the square of the hypotenuse. Let us have a look at the theorem. This is a right angle triangle, very important. It is true only for right angle triangle. These are three sides. So the Pythagoras theorem says that the a square plus b square would be equal to c square. Pictorially you can see a square and b square, the sum of these two squares would be equal to c square. So where can we use Pythagoras theorem? We can use this theorem to find the third side of a right angle triangle if two sides are given. Let's see an example. Suppose we have a right angle triangle with the side, one side equal to 3 and side B equal to 4. We need to find the side C, that is the hypotenuse. So since we know that Pythagoras theorem is A square plus B square is equal to C square, so 3 square plus 4 square would be equal to c square. Now 3 square is 9 and 4 square is 16. So 9 plus 16 is 25. So c square is equal to 25 and c would be equal to 5. That is under root of 25. So here you can see that if you know the two sides, we can find the third side. Now let us prove Pythagoras theorem. Friends, there are many ways of proving Pythagoras theorem. Let us see a few of them. Now let this be a line and you select any point on this line. Now here you can see the point on the left side can be categorized as A, on the right side B. Now let's draw a square like this. And on another side, let's select another point as shown, the side A and B. If you join these two points, let this be C. Now similarly, on all remaining two sides, we select the point with the distance which is A and B from both sides. Now let us join all these points. So what we see is that we find a smaller square in between the bigger square. The bigger square side is A plus B and the smaller square side is C. So this is what the figure that we have obtained. Now area of the smaller square is nothing but C square. Let us see the area of this triangle. The area of this triangle would nothing but half into A into B. Similarly, the area of other three triangles will also be equal to half into A into B. Okay, let us see what is the total area of the square, the bigger square. Total area, since we have four smaller triangles, so it will be 4 into half into A into B, and the smaller square, which the area we have already calculated as C square. So this becomes 2AB plus C square. Now total area of the square is also equal to A plus B whole square, since the side of the bigger square is nothing but A plus B. Now we know that A plus B whole square is equal to A square plus B square plus 2AB. So equating these two equations, what we get is a plus b whole square plus 2ab is equal to 2ab plus c square. So here we can cancel out 2ab on both the side, and what remains with us is a square plus b square is equal to c square. And this is what is Pythagoras theorem. Okay, now let us see another way to prove Pythagoras theorem. Now here we are going to use the properties of similar triangles, and for that we need to draw a perpendicular from the point B to the side AC. All we need to prove is that, because if you see this triangle, it has three triangles, two smaller triangles and one big right triangle. The two smaller triangles and one big right triangle. What we need to prove is that the smaller triangles are similar to the bigger triangle. Now in this triangle, this is ABC and ADB. Now angle A is equal to angle A, clear. Angle B is equal to angle D, 90 degrees, that is by construction. So if two angles in the triangles are equal, the third angle will automatically be equal, that is angle C will be equal to angle ABD. So these two triangles are similar by AA criteria. And if these two triangles are similar, then AB by AD is equal to AC by AB. So you see AB square would be equal to AD into AC. Let's remember this result. Now let's see if the triangle ABC and BDC. Here angle C is equal to angle C, angle B is equal to angle D, which is equal to 90 degrees. So if two angles are equal, the third angle becomes automatically equal. So angle A would be equal to angle CBD. So we see that the triangle ABC is similar to triangle BDC by AA criteria. And if these two triangles are similar, then BC by CD is equal to AC by BC. So BC square is nothing but CD into AC. So we have seen that AB square is equal to AD into AC, and BC square is equal to CD into AC. Let's add these two equations. So adding the left hand side, we get AB square plus BC square is equal to AD into AC plus CD into AC. Now if you see the right hand side of this equation, AC is common, so you take out AC, so it becomes AC into AD plus CD. Now AC, AD plus CD is nothing but AC itself. So AB square plus BC square is nothing but AC into AC, which is AB square plus BC square is equal to AC square. So you have seen that how we can prove the Pythagoras theorem very easily just by using similar triangles. Now in the next video, we'll learn something more about exponents. So stay tuned and please subscribe if not already done so. Thank you so much for watching.